Alright guys, so today we are going to be remaking the Fractal Design Kelvin S24 all-in-one water cooling kit over here. So let's open this up. You can actually take this apart and separate components, add components, remove components, swap components, and basically customize it like you would an all-in-one customize an all-in-one liquid cooler into a custom loop. So, got a couple of fans over here. They're not great, they have good static pressure, but they're a bit loud, so I'm not going to be using them. Here you've got all your mounting hardware, and here we have the water cooling radiator and block. So let's put this box away. And we're gonna need some tools over here. So we got plastic Tupperware, which we're gonna use to put the fluid in. We're not gonna be reusing this fluid though. We're gonna be using some EK coolant because we're gonna be adding stuff and we're gonna need more. So what's in here is not gonna be enough. Let's just unbox that. We don't need these right now. Got instruction manual here. All right, so here we go. I'm gonna be rebuilding this, changing out the tubing and eventually the radiator and fittings. And we're gonna be keeping this, which is the pump and CPU water block. And the reason why I got this cooling system is actually just for this block, which is a pump and block combined. And I'm gonna be painting it. So to do that, we're gonna need to take it apart and empty the fluid into this Tupperware. So there is a fill port here, but I'm gonna need to remove the tubing anyway to make it easier to paint. So we're just gonna take these compression fittings, we're gonna turn them to loosen them, and just keep turning, and they should come out very soon. We don't want to have a lot of liquid spilling all over the place, so that's where we're going to put it all into this Tupperware. And it's almost out. Okay, so that's a spring, and there we go. Just pull the tubing and all the liquid will fall out, just like that. And we want to drain it from the pump. Being careful though to not get any of this fluid onto the pump itself. So now we're going to hold this here in this position and we're going to lift up the radiator. And that will make all of the coolant flow out. Just like that. Still a bit more in there. And still a bit more. Basically, I'm putting the radiator vertically so that we can get all of the coolant out of there. Shake it around a bit. Turn it at different angles. Alright. I think that's most of it. So, now that we've got this, let's see, what am I going to do with this? Put this over here for just a second. Let's get some tissue papers, dry this up so it doesn't drip all over the place. This pump over here, don't want it touching that. Spilled a bit of water over here. This is just distilled water, so it's all right. It's not toxic or anything. Just get the last few drops out of here. All right, I think that's most of it. Let's just dry this up over here, and oh. Got a bit more coolant there again. Okay, I think this is about it. So let's take off the other fitting though. Let's unscrew this, and now we should be able to just pull the tubing out. And there we go. Alright, so, whoops. So about a bit of liquid inside this block over here. Let's put this down for now. Dry this up. Alright, now that we've got these two separated, we should just get the last drops out of this. It's actually got a lot more fluid inside than I expected. So it's a really big block, actually, for an all-in-one liquid cooler. So you can take these compression fittings off like that. And it's pretty small tubing. I'm going to be replacing it with some of this, which I painted white. This is the EK-ZMT. Very nice tubing. A lot thicker. So we're also going to be replacing these two fittings with some Bits Power fittings. But that's not what we're doing right now. Right now we're just going to get ready to paint it. And yeah, so just make sure all the last drops are out of it. Yeah, that's basically it. We just disconnected the radiator from the CPU block over here, and now we need to get ready to paint it. So for that, we're gonna get some tape. Just like that. And we wanna make sure we tape off all the parts that we don't want to get paint on. So, whoops, I just put that cable into that liquid right there. It's okay, it will dry. That's not a problem. So, here we've got this. We don't want paint going into these fittings here, because we don't want absolutely anything to get inside of the water block. So, we're just gonna put some tape over it like this to keep paint from going in there. And same for the other one. Like that. I don't care about getting paint on these fittings though, since I'm not going to be using them. That's not going to be a problem. If you are going to be using them again, then you want to cover up the whole fitting with tape. But I don't really care if I get paint on it, so that's not a problem. Just cover it up like this. Maybe add one more piece over here. Just like that. Now we've got both of them covered up, and there's not going to be any paint getting in there. So, yeah. I also want to protect this cable, though. I don't want the cable to get painted white, so for that, we're going to put a piece of tape around the opening here. Like that. And for the rest of the cable, we can either wrap it in tape or put a piece of paper around it or something. I think tape will be easiest here, since it's just one long cable. And then after painting, you can just take all this off and it will be perfectly fine. So, that. Cable here. Okay, and we're done. This is basically ready for painting, except for the last part, of course. We don't want to get paint on the bottom of the block here, which is the part that contacts the CPU, the copper bottom. Want to cover that up with tape as well. Okay, and now we're gonna take some scissors and cut this extra tape off here, the sides. Alright, you want the paint to go all the way around but not touch the copper. And also you'll notice this ridge around here. This is where the mounting brackets go. So we can't, if we get paint in there, they won't fit properly. So we also want to cover that up. And so for this, we'll just go around the side like that. Okay, so the bottom of the block is now completely protected with tape, and we've got tape going around the sides here where the mounting brackets go. This doesn't really matter if you cover it up, because I'm not going to be using it for filling this loop, so that's not a problem. And the cable is also all wrapped up, and oh, there's a couple spots here where the tape's unsticking. But yeah, basically, no paint is going to get on anything except for this pump water block. And the fittings, of course, but those don't matter. So yeah, that's basically it. It's ready for painting. And now all we have left over here is the tubing and the radiator. So as I said, I'm not going to be using this, but I don't have my new radiator yet, so I think I'm actually going to use this one just for a while. So let's remove the fittings from the side. So we're gonna unscrew these, and they're pretty tight, but okay, so I finally got those fittings loosened up. I had to use this because they were on a lot harder than the two on the block were. So that took a while, but I finally got them loose. So now all we have to do is unscrew these. And let's put this down here. And same for the other one. And there we go. So you can see the compression fitting actually pulled out the barb from the radiator. So you can see the two pieces are still together. So obviously they were put on very tight, but since I'm replacing the fittings anyway, I actually needed to pull those out too. So this just got two things done in one at once. So that's pretty good. We got the radiator here. There's probably some stuff left in it though. So we'll just make sure that there's nothing dripping. Yep, there's still stuff. And there we go. Got the radiator. It's pretty much completely empty now. And both of the barbs are out. We're not going to be using those. We're not going to be using this tubing. We can just put that stuff away. And there we go. So nice new radiator we've got here. This is a 2x120mm, and yeah, I guess I'll be using this temporarily. I can show you guys here the fittings I'm going to be using. So these here are Bits Power Deluxe White 3/8 inch to 5/8 inch tubing. These are barbs. And over here we've got barbs on 90 degree rotary adapters. And these are just going to be going over here to replace these ones. And these ones are going to be going onto the radiator. So they'll just go just like this. All right. So I'll get to painting, and I guess I'll show you guys the results afterwards. Alright, so here we are. We're going to try filling the loop for the first time. So we have everything we need over here. Plastic Tupperware that's mostly clean. I have 1 liter of EK clear coolant fluid here, which we're going to use to fill the loop. We have all the components. We have the CPU block, the tubing, radiator. I actually used different tubing. I painted these ones first, and I didn't like how they turned out, so I redid it, and this time I used a short piece of tubing and a long piece of tubing just to make it easier to fit where I'm gonna place it in the system. Over here we have a syringe which will help with filling the loop. We have the tubing clamps here. We're gonna need to put these on. The screws, screwdriver, and over here we have a spare power supply which has been hot wired so that it's on, turns on automatically when I hit the switch. Here I have a fan plug, and this is connected to 12 volts. So we're going to take our CPU block pump water block over here, and we're going to connect this to the power supply. So now the red and black cables from here go into the red and black cables on the fan cable, and those go into a yellow cable and a black cable from the power supply. So that's going to give us 12 volts, and when we turn this on with the switch on the back, our pump will start running so we can fill the loop. Now, first step is going to be to get these little tubing clamps on, because we're going to need to put the tubing on this thing. So it's going to go into my PC like this, which means the shorter piece of tubing is going to go on this side. And before we put the tubing on, you want to put the tubing clamp onto the tubing. So it should go on like this. Alright, now finally got the tubing on after a bit of struggling. You can see the two clamps are on there. And all that's left to do now is get two of the screws and put them through. And there we go. So don't have to put them too tight, but just enough so that it's going to hold the tubing in place and there's no chance of leaks. And yeah, so that's it for this side. Now what we need to do is get our radiator right over here, figure out how it's going to be mounted in the computer. I'm going to have mine like this, and That means we need to have one side in and one side out. But first of all, the pump, we want to have one of the tubing runs from the pump that's going to be coming in, and one's going to be going out. So we need to figure out first which one is which, basically. So what we're going to do for that is just take our little bottle of liquid here. We're going to open this up, press down and turn, and there we go. Now what we're going to do is take our syringe, and does it reach? No, it's not going to reach from here. Alright, so first of all, we're just going to pour some into this container we've got here. Alright, so that was maybe a quarter of a bottle. That's what we're going to start to use to fill our loop. So let's fill the syringe. Make sure we don't get any drops, and we're going to start filling the pump. Alright, so this piece of tubing is full. Now let's just bend this over a bit. Alright, and now we're going to start filling the top piece of tubing here. Okay, so basically now we just got a bit of water inside the pump, and we're going to find out which one of these two pieces of tube the water is going to go in and which one's going to come out. So yeah, basically there is a bunch of air still inside this water block over here, but this special Fractal Design pump and CPU block has been designed to run in air without getting damaged. So usually water cooling pumps will get damaged, but this one is going to be fine if it gets some air in it. So we have it hooked up to our PC, and I'm just going to cover this just in case it comes out really fast, but we're just going to turn it on for a second, see which one water comes out, which one water doesn't. Okay, so it seems like it's coming out from the bottom, but there's still a bunch of air, so I'm going to try this again. See if we can get a bit more water inside that block. So, okay, I think both tubings are filled with water now, so let's try this again one more time. Okay, so now we know the water's coming in through the top, coming out through this bottom tube over here. So if you basically look at your Kelvin pump from the front with the tubes coming out the right side, the top tube is the intake and the bottom tube is the out. So now that we know that, let's pour any excess liquid out. Just like that, that will be enough. Dry this off a bit. Okay, now what we're gonna do is connect the radiator the same way we connected the tubing to the pump. So first of all, we're just gonna get these which power clamps on. And yeah, we're going to connect the water out from the pump into the radiator. So the one that's water in, we're just going to leave this loose for now. Alright, so here we go. We've got the pump water output connected to the radiator. And then we've just got the inlet that's empty. and we've got the outlet on the radiator that's also empty. So the next step we have to do is fill the loop. So temporarily connect a piece of tubing to the water out of the radiator, just quickly like that. This is going to be our return tube. So I'm going to take some tape over here, and we need this tube to return fluid over here to the reservoir. This is going to be our temporary reservoir, this bucket of water, and this is going to return all the fluid that's excess. Next, this is going to be our intake. So first of all, we need to fill this with fluid, and then we are going to add more fluid in here so that we can have a continuously cycling loop. So let's add more. That's about half the bottle. We'll try this for now. Now let's fill the loop. So we're going to keep doing this until water comes out of this black tube over here. Alright, we just got a bit of water coming out. Let's try one more syringe and then we're going to try turning it on. Alright, so it seems like we have full circulation now. The water is coming in through one tube, coming out through the other. And we're going to help get all the bubbles out, so let's just pour more liquid in here. And that's basically 1 liter of water cooling fluid. So we've got continuous circulation, water's coming in, water's coming out. We have bubbles that are coming out over there. We want to try to get as much air out of the loop as possible. So that means shaking the pump around, try to get bubbles out, shaking the radiator. See if we can get all of the bubbles out of there too. And basically we just have to leave it circulating for a while until we see that there's no more bubbles coming out of this tube. Alright guys, so sadly, an unfortunate event happened while I was recording filling of this loop, and this camera fell into the liquid cooling fluid, and yes, the camera fell in the fluid, and then I had to take it out, dry it. Luckily it wasn't on, and I basically just let it dry overnight, and it's still working, as you can see. But yeah, I wasn't able to record the rest of the filling of the loop, so I'm just going to show you guys what I did here and explain it. But sadly I don't have a video of actually finishing filling it and putting it together because of the camera falling in the water. So here it is. It's basically all filled now. There are still micro bubbles inside, which I wasn't able to get out. But here's the fluid. You can see it's all the way up to here. We used about one third here, and some of it spilled and I had to throw a bit away. So basically, this loop here just took up about 250 milliliters, one quarter of this 1 liter bottle. But if you have a bit of spare money, I would recommend actually buying two or three of these 1 liter bottles to make the process easier. You can have more fluid inside the container when you're filling, and that will basically just make everything easier when you're filling the loop. So basically, as you can see before, I just had one off. I filled this part and then circulated the loop, and then all I had to do was then put this part of the radiator, the one with the open barb, stick it under the water, and then just connect this tube and the radiator while this part was under the water. So yeah, it wasn't too difficult, but I did get a few bubbles in it. Before, I had the tubing like this, so bent like this, and while I was circulating the loop, and the problem is that a bubble can get stuck up here. So even though there was full circulation, there was actually still a bit of air in the top of this tube. So when you're filling, you want to try to not have any high points that are like a tube that bends like this, and then you'll get air stuck up there, because air will go up. So you just want to try to keep all the highest points open. So like where the fluid is coming out of the radiator, you want that to be the highest point. And then just connect the tubing underwater. And also over here, you'll see on the bottom of the Fractal Design pump CPU block, there is this little thing here. You can open it up with an Allen wrench. Make sure that this is the highest point of the loop. So the radiator is down here, and then you'll see this up here. And then you can unscrew this and top it off with a bit of fluid, get a bit of air out, and then just put the cap back on. It just screws on with an Allen wrench, so that makes filling it quite a bit easier. But you want to get most of the fluid in before you actually connect the tubing, because yeah, you can just get a few air bubbles out of this, you won't be able to get all the air bubbles out. So as I said, I wasn't able to perfectly fill this because I didn't have enough fluid, and there's still a few air bubbles. But when this is installed in the system, it's going to be like this, and this part over here is going to be the highest point of the loop. So bubbles actually get stuck up here, and the fluid just circulates, and the bubbles here will not circulate through the loop. That's what causes a lot of pump noise if you've got micro bubbles going around and around. But yeah, basically this is almost silent, so I'm going to turn it on here and I'll give you guys a listen. So you can see it's actually very, very quiet. From here you probably can't hear it at all. There we go. So it's basically all ready. All of the tubing is clamped on now and it's filled with fluid. All that's left to do is install this inside the PC, and it will be set. So yep, that's the next thing I've got to do.
Alright guys, so I got this installed, and yeah, I still have to test it to see if it works, but you can see here I got everything mounted, and a couple flaws. This tubing here is a bit too long, could have made that shorter. From here, it looks like it might touch the side panel window, but I think it's going to be okay. And also back there, this fitting here, what I was afraid of, it's actually touching the heatsink, but it fits, but it got scratched, so it's going to be okay. But yeah, it's mounted, and all I have to do now is plug it in and make sure it works.
Okay guys, so here it is, it's installed, and yeah, you can see it looks a lot better than the H100 I had before. So you can see the tubing's going up at the top over there, it's actually touching the heat sinks at the top of my motherboard.
But yeah, it's a big CPU water block, so not much I can do about that. Here's the radiator. When I have more money, I'm going to be replacing that with a Alpha Cool Nexus Monster 280mm radiator, which is larger and a lot thicker too. So it will basically be about this thick. And that's going to offer a lot more cooling, but it's going to cost over $150. So for now, I'm just using the stock one that I painted, and it's working well. This tubing, you can see, is still too long. It's actually touching the plastic side panel over here, and I could have shortened that, but I wasn't exactly sure of the measurements. So when I install the new radiator, I'll probably remove that and cut the tube a bit more, since I'll need to refill it anyways. But it's turned out pretty good. Something I noticed is that this pump is louder than the H100i I had in there before. So if you listen closely, you can actually hear the pump vibrating a bit. Maybe hard to hear, but it is louder, and I don't know. I was expecting it to be a bit quieter, but it does have to be a more powerful pump, because this is an expandable system, so you can add graphics cards and radiators to it. So it does need to be more powerful, but it is also a bit louder, sadly. I noticed that it's not as loud when it's not touching anything, if I'm just holding it in my hand, but when the pump is mounted to the motherboard here, or when it's lying on a hard surface, it actually passes the vibrations and it basically becomes louder. It's still pretty quiet, very quiet for a PC. I'm actually going for very, very low noise over here, so that's why it's kind of noticeable. But if you're looking to get this for a future custom water cooling loop or whatever, and you want it in your PC, then it's going to be very quiet. So yeah, I have to say this is a success. Looks very nice, and that's basically it. Finished for now. I'll do another update when I replace the radiator, and I'll take that chance to make the tubing the right size. But for now, it's finished. I'm getting good temperatures, 64 degrees Celsius, where before with the H100i, I used to get 68 Celsius under full load. And this radiator is the same size, same fans, basically a couple millimeters thicker. And I can't wait to see the temps that I will get with the Alpha Cool radiator, which is multiple times bigger than this. So, yep, it's working well, and it's reasonably quiet. So, thank you guys for watching, and if you have any questions, just leave them in the description, and, well, in the comments below the description. And thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.